god! Oh my god! Look at our baby girl!
She is going to do great things. I know it. It is her destiny.
Look, the theaters have been closed for 18 years because of civil wars and the protectorate. But it is time to change that. We will have two companies running everything. And women are beautiful. I want to see them on stage. Therefore, I decree women may act.
Wow, this slavery thing is really fucked up. I think it's time for me to go back to England.
I do.
They have the blood!
It's okay, my love. You must do great things.
It is your destiny.
I know that you want to start working in theater, but your country needs you. The Dutch wars are in full swing. Your husband was Dutch, and you're a total badass, and I want you to be a spy.
What? What would I be doing?
We need you to go to Antwerp, Belgium, and gather intel about the exiled Cromwellians and Dutch military strategies.
Can I have a cool code name?
Fine.
Bet. I will go by Australia.
Charles, I have been here for 4 years. I know I am not the best spy, but I am dedicated and I need money. I have always been an ardent supporter of you. Since you have not responded to my many inquiries, I have no choice but to come back to England and follow my passion, writing.
Your dad is going to prison.
Ha! You finally get out of prison for being broke, and now you want to make a living as a writer? No woman has ever done that before.
Exactly! Women are not treated right. People see them as objects and property. No longer. I am hilarious. I'm going to write political satire and point out injustices, while also telling a damn good and a damn funny story.
Well, that all sounds good and great, but how?
Well, the political climate is whack right now. Theater's becoming really politicized. Plus, I have a vision. Restoration Theater is creating this new, intimate relationship between the actors and the audience. I'm going to take advantage of that and create special effects, illusions, and beautiful costumes.
Okay. Good luck.
Why should the Duke Theater Company, one of two theater patents in England currently, allow you, a woman, to work for us?
Look, it's the late 1600s, a time of change in economics, sexuality, and politics. If you allow me, I can create productions at the intersections of politics and popular culture.
Not sure. Restoration stage techniques are still fairly new. I'm not sure how a woman could handle it.
I'm very familiar with the restoration stage. I love the way that prologues and epilogues are used to construct narrative. I want to help advance stage machinery, dance, and create complex plots. I can do this. It's my destiny.
Fine, but don't come crying to me when you fail.
No more than you have in an engagement or a tempest.
Ehab, thou art a brave girl, and I admire thy loving courage. Lead on, no other dangers they can dread. Who ventures in the storms of a marriage bed?
I gotta admit, you did a good job here. The Wilmore really embodies the wild, gallant character people like to see in this era of theater, and a witty female heroine.
Who would have thunk?
See, I told you, women are not just one identity. They are multifaceted and have a range of femininity. They shouldn't be held to these horrible moral standards of chastity.
Whoa, there. Let's not get carried away. Aye, aye, aye.
All right, but I'm not done yet. I'm sick of human sexuality being something taboo, especially for women. You know, my secret lover, John Hoyle? He told me he likes to have sex with men and women. And I like to have sex with him! Why shouldn't we be talking about female desire?
Now, as you know, I attend theater rather than have shows brought to my court. It's a big reason why theater has become such a social activity in my kingdom, but to be honest, I'm getting concerned.
The people are restless, sir. There's talk of a Protestant revolution.
And after I advocated for religious tolerance, even as a Catholic, and this is how they repay me. The Clarendon Code Licensing Act of 1662 was supporting Stop This Dissent under the guise of libel and slander, course. But they still chatter. And then Aphra Behn, she's dangerous.
Hey, it's the famous Aphra Behn. Where are all those men you found so they'll write your stories for you?
All my works are my own.
Go away.
I decided I need to address my main concern about women, forced marriage, even more than I already have been. I will not stand for misogyny.
So, after your show about forced marriage, what's next?
Well, you know the king's illegitimate son, Duke of Monmouth. Well, I want to criticize him in one of the epilogues.
You're crazy.
The play's performing right now, I'll be fine. What are they gonna do, arrest me?
You're under arrest, under...
Okay, I might have overdone it this time.
Well, I'm back from my leave of absence after being arrested again. What's next for me? I remember in my 20s, I spent time in the Indies, and I have to say, I'm not a big fan of slavery. You know what? I'm gonna write the first fictive work in England to attack slavery.
Please, don't go.
It's my time. I am poor, sick, and old. For heaven's sake, I'm 49. Besides, I changed the social and political landscape of British comedian theater. Especially tragic comedies. I have achieved my destiny. I can go. In peace.
Action!
It's not my fault! Wait, no. Oh my god, you can do it! I can punish brain! Wait! Oh my god!
Well, I want to Chris!